I went to Easter House. Is there anyone in from Easter? Wow, Easter House is incredible. That is the only place I've ever been where you see toddlers walking around with muzzles on so they don't rip off Rottweiler's faces. Scary. But you see, this is the thing. People think of Glasgow as being quite tough. I think that is great. Because with Glaswegians, you know exactly where you stand, and that should be celebrated. Like, at the beginning of the week, right, I arrived in Glasgow and I decided what I needed to start off my week in Glasgow was to go and get myself a big breakfast. That's what I need, with some food inside me. So I set off into the middle of Glasgow to find, like, a traditional greasy spoon Scottish cafe. And I find the perfect one, right? I walk in, there's a waiter who's really dour-faced, staring at me, wishing that I was dead with every fibre of his being. I sat down and I ordered myself a big, big bowl of Birka muesli with all the fruits. And I took out my laptop and started typing away, you know, a little bit of work on the show. And then I made the fatal error of asking my newfound friend, the waiter in the cafe, whether he had any Wi-Fi access. To which he looked at me as if to say, I haven't even got access to my fucking kids. So at this point, I wasn't feeling particularly well-loved. But then, thank God, the best thing that could possibly happen in this situation then occurred. A godsend, ladies and gentlemen, an American couple walked in. And all of a sudden, I was no longer public enemy number one. They come in, hey, Marty, come in here, they're definitely gonna have Wi-Fi. As soon as they've come into the cafe, the waiter, he's caught them coming in, he's having, like, a xenophobic stroke in the corner. Yankee Doodle fucking bitch coming into my fucking cafe. I'll take a shit in an omelette. And she's there, she's eating away really loudly, slurping on her coffee. She gets to the end of her coffee, right? She slams it down and starts clicking at the waiter. I'm like, oh my God, this shit could get messy. duck for cover, duck for cover. She goes, sir, I finished my coffee. I will now have my free refill of coffee. Oh dear. He did not like that. He looked at her like she just ordered dead baby soup or something without batter. It was awful. And he couldn't even formulate a response. He tried to say something, but no sentence came out of his mouth. After like a minute of just aching and squealing, eventually he managed to shit out just a, no! She, cool as a cucumber, goes, sir, I'm gonna give you a little reality check here, okay? A little reality check. In America, if you order a coffee, we give you a free refill. In front of everyone in the cafe, he looked her dead in the eye and goes, love, in Glasgow, we don't give a fuck. Stood up to shout freedom, and she got kicked out of the